Easy and be merciful to us. angels we cry aloud, glory to God on high. And again with the shepherds to whom they announced and said, peace on earth we beseech you, O good hope of our souls. Have pity and be merciful to us.
Oh. living Son, the living sign, holy baptism.
Oh.
Fragrant oil upon your head. May that innocence, which we place for your honor, and for the pardon of our decency.
Christ the Lord. This will be a sign for you.
you will find the baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger. And suddenly there appeared with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among men with whom he is pleased. When the angels had gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds began saying to one another, Let us go straight to Bethlehem then, and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us. So they came in a hurry and found their way to Mary and Joseph, and the baby as he lay in the manger. When they had seen this, they made known the statement which had been told them about this child. And all who heard it wondered at the things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary treasured all these things, pondering them in her heart. The shepherds went back, glorifying and praising God for all that they had heard and seen, just as had been told them. Glory be to Christ our Lord.
Glory be to Christ our Lord.
Let us all stand up as it is befitting, with joy and rejoicing. Let us beseech and say, Our Lord, have mercy upon us.
Upon us.
Father, O
yourself in your grace and mercies, O good one and lover of mankind, Lord of all, Father and Son and Holy Spirit forever.
Amen. Bless our Lord. Bow down your head in the position of hands and receive the blessing.
Accept this sacrifice at our hands by his grace and mercies forever. Amen.
Amen.
Lord, command the world and our God.
Amen. Bless her, my Lord.
By your command the world and our God.
Amen. Bless her, my Lord.
By your command the world and our God.
May we be made worthy to enter into the Holy of Holies, the high and exalted,
and in purity, excellence, and holiness, may we stand before your holy altar and offer to you spiritual and rational sacrifices in the true faith. But you who are good and do not anger forever, nor forever keeps his wrath, turn your face away from my sins and blot out all my foolishness by the great multitude of your mercifulness, Father and Son and Holy Spirit, forever.
Amen.
In the truth and all which is undivided.
We believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, the firstborn of all creations, who was begotten of his Father before all worlds were not made, true God, of one essence with his Father, by whose hands the worlds were established, and all things were created, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit, and became man, was conceived and born of the Virgin Mary, and suffered and was crucified in the days of Pontius Pilate, and was buried and rose on the third day as it is written, and ascended into heaven, and sat at the right hand of his Father, and shall come again to judge the dead and the living, and in one Holy Spirit, the Spirit of truth, who proceeds from the Father, the life-giving Spirit, and in one holy and apostolic and Catholic Church, and we confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and in the resurrection of our bodies, and in the life forever and ever. Amen.
May God, the Lord of all, be with us all in us all, by his grace and mercies forever. Amen.
Sacrifice.
listen to you.
Oh, Of the precious heart. And every feast of the resurrection,
our beloved patriarch, Mar Bincha, His Holiness, Mar Bincha, has written to us the patriarchal epistle that is to be read out in all of our churches at this time, this blessed time, this time of rejoicing. And I will read this to you accordingly. The patriarchal epistle for the holy feast of the Nativity of our Lord Jesus Christ for the year 2014. Our beloved brothers, noble prelates, our spiritual sons, the elect priests, and pure deacons, sons and daughters of the Holy Church and the Syrian National Group, and all our Christian brothers and sisters, our prayers and blessings you may receive. Today, the feast of the Holy Nativity of our Lord Jesus Christ brought a great joy into every Christian home. Thus, we should not forget the love and mercy of our Heavenly Father toward mankind. God, as a gracious, righteous, and just God, is always concerned about keeping the work of His hand, the man whom He has created in His image and likeness, pure and without blemish. He does not desire the lovely image He has created to be stained by sin. We are bound to pray and offer thanksgiving unto our Heavenly Father for His maternal love and mercy toward mankind by sending His only begotten Son unto the world in order to save human race from death and sin. A great miracle took place in Bethlehem of Judea on the day of the Nativity of Jesus Christ. Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David, a Saviour who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling cloths lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a great multitude of heavenly hosts praising God, saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." Luke chapter 2, verse 8 to 14. Let us too, along with the angels, raise glory unto God on behalf of His love and kindness for sending peace upon earth. Today, more than ever, we are in need of the same divine peace to be sent into those countries which are extremely in need of peace, so that their inhabitants will have hope to live peacefully. Christians in the Middle East, in general, and the sons and daughters of our Assyrian National Group in particular, are beseeching the Lord of Peace, the merciful God, to make it possible for them to go back to their homes, villages, and their cities, and live in peace without fear with their neighbors. Our Lord Jesus Christ says, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you." John chapter 14, verse 27. Now we have realized that our Lord has given us peace and good hope. Let us believe on the day of the Nativity of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Savior of the world. The shepherds beheld a great host of heavenly beings, along with the angels praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace and goodwill toward men." The source of peace and hope is Jesus Christ. Therefore, let us not stay away from the Lord so that we will avoid being lost in the world. It is expected of us to be faithful, obedient, and safeguard His commandments. It is appropriate that we too should pray and say, "Glory to God in the highest, for His gracious loving kindness toward mankind, for sending His Son." Christians all over the world are delighted on the day of the feast of the Holy Nativity of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We are all together as members of one extended Christian family are celebrating in love the feast of the Nativity of our Lord and saying to all of you, O sons and daughters of the Holy Church and our Assyrian national group and to all fellow Christians, the feast of the Nativity of our Lord Jesus Christ be blessed to you all. As the glory of the Lord shone around the shepherds on the day of the Nativity of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, after the same manner, may it shine and enlighten the hearts and minds of all the world national groups and nationals and nations, so that they can be able to live together upon the surface of this world in love and tranquility. Christians of today, more than ever, are in need to have trust, love, peace, and respect toward one another. The structure of our Christian faith and our Assyrian national group must be erected upon a stable and strong foundation, because the lack of trust in one another is causing obstacles in the path of ecclesiastical and national unity. Whenever there is a lack of faith, no doubt there will be a lack of love, respect, and obedience towards one another as well. Hence the division, hatred, anger, and disrespect are originating. And the result of all the above mentioned will definitely be the cause of weakness and significant loss to us all ecclesiastically and nationally. We pray and are beseeching God, the same peace which He has sent by means of the heavenly hosts on the day of the Nativity of His Son Jesus Christ, may bring all the Christians closer to one another. Jesus Christ established only one church on earth, and He is the head and the guardian of it. Even though today the Holy Church is divided and called by many different names, yet at the end we are all Christians. A Christian should not disrespect his fellow Christian regardless to his denominational belonging. A Christian, as brothers and sisters of one another in Christ, must participate in joy and sadness of one another. Our Lord Jesus Christ has commanded us to love one another. It is written, "This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you." John chapter 15, verse 12. If we Christians work together respectfully, in a humble spirit and pure heart, we will all equally rejoice in the love and peace of Christ. As members of one Assyrian national group, we are related to one another by having the same blood, language, history, and homeland. The unity and progress of our national group brings joy to all of us. In the other hand, the division and the decline of our national group brings sadness to all of us. This is the reason that all Christian sons and daughters of our Assyrian national group, regardless of their denominational belonging, must be watchful and alert to maintain the peace and unity of our national group and to faithfully work together as sons and daughters of one Assyrian national group. They should choose to stay away from hatred, covetousness, uselessness, and destructive strife, those which cause great damage to the unity and success of our national group and our Holy Apostolic Catholic Assyrian Church of the East, which our Lord established. Jesus Christ is not calling the buildings made of stones the church, but rather He means the congregation of those who have believed in Him.
Jesus commissioned his apostles, saying, "Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things that I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the age. Amen." Matthew chapter 28, verse 19 to 20. Sacrament of the holy baptism is a spiritual mother who gave birth to all of us as brothers and sisters, members of one Christian household. Therefore, we must love and support one another. I urge all the sons and daughters of our holy church to be supportive of the prelates, priests, who are in dire need of their help. Every single member of the Holy Church is responsible toward the Church. His responsibility is not merely to pay his or her tithe, but rather the utmost and most important obligation of a member of the Church are maintaining the apostolic faith of the Holy Church, keeping the canon laws of the Holy Church, and regularly attending the spiritual services and celebration of the Holy Eucharistic, and listening to the divine words of God preached by the prelates, priests, and deacons. We ask you all, O sons and daughters of our Holy Church, to participate in the classes of Messianic teachings which are offered in your parishes. Your younger children should be brought to the Sunday and Friday schools, where they all will be taught the prayers, basic faith, and a Syrian liturgical language. All your young sons and daughters must be encouraged to join the youth association of your holy church. It is expected of them to join the choir of the parish, attend the Bible study programs, and learn both reading and writing of the liturgical Assyrian language. The children and young people are the future of our church and our Assyrian national group. We acquire the Christian faith from hearing and listening to the divine words of God written in the sacred scriptures, read and preached by the prelates, priests, and faithful preachers of Christ. We ask you all, O sons and daughters of our Holy Church and of our Assyrian national group, in the country in which you are resident or citizens, be faithful and obedient to the constitution bylaws of your country, and be obedient to the governmental authorities, so that you may be respected and loved by officials of the country of your residency, and you will live in joy and peace with your neighbors. As sons and daughters of the Assyrian Church of the East, keep your faith, liturgy, and apostolic traditions of the Church with great care. In the country you may reside, try to live a Christian life. Be proud that you are sons and daughters of the Assyrian Church of the East. You should never be embarrassed or afraid that you are a Christian. As a national group, be always proud that you are Assyrians, keeping your Assyrian name high. Study your history and learn your Assyrian and Aramaic language. Your unity and love toward one another must be pure and true. In conclusion, we are again saying, the feast of the Nativity of our Lord Jesus Christ be blessed to you all along with the new year of 2015. We pray the upcoming new year will bring peace and tranquility in all corners of the world in general, and in particular in the Middle Eastern countries. We pray for the mutual understanding, peace and unity of the whole Christian Church. We pray for the good health and prosperity of all the sons and daughters of of the Holy Church of our Lord Jesus Christ, and for all the sons and daughters of our Assyrian national group. The grace and mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all forever and ever. Amen. Written in our Patriarchal See, Morton Grove, 10th of December 2014, Hanania Mardenfa IV, by grace, Catholicos Patriarch of the Assyrian Church of the East. Wonderful words at a wonderful time given to all of us who have gathered here today to celebrate the wonderful birth of our Lord Jesus Christ, full of wonders in order to make us stenches before the Lord into a beautiful fragrance and delightful aroma by the love and peace and grace and mercy that we have received through the baptism that He has given us at the cost of His own life and at the strength of His own resurrection. This is a time for all of us to put aside petty and foolish differences. Let us come together with love, with joy, with respect one another, as our Holy Father said to us, to be united as one body, for Christ alone is the head of this body. The past, God is willing to forgive. The present, God is forgiving. And even the sins that we commit in the future, God is merciful enough to receive our request for forgiveness and forgive us yet again, time and time again, even though we break our promise quite often. For many of us, it is the first time coming to church for a long time. Pick up where you left off. Do not feel that you will be looked upon, frowned upon, but instead, every time a sinner repents, there are angels in heaven rejoicing and praising God for doing another great thing. How many of us today have made the angels rejoice in heaven because we have come back to the flock carried in the arms of our loving shepherd that went looking for us? That beautiful loving shepherd that we remember the wonderful birth that he was born into this world to save mankind. God bless you, and I will now pray the prayer of absolution, so that we may be cleansed, forgiven, and made worthy to partake in the precious body and blood of our Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. O our good God and full of mercy, O our good God and full of mercy, whose grace and compassion are abundant upon all, pour, O my Lord, the kindness of your pleasant love on these servants of yours, and transform them in the hope of renewal to the life of repentance. Renew in them your Holy Spirit, by whom they are sealed for the day of salvation, and purify them in your kindness from all the blemishes of the flesh and of the spirit. Strengthen the hope of their belief by the help of your grace. Make straight the gates of their deeds and the paths of righteousness. Make them to rejoice with the saints in your kingdom in the confirmation of the hope of their faith of the adoption of sonship and in the joy of your absolving mysteries. Strengthen them by the aid of your mercy to observe your commandments and to fulfill your will, to confess, worship, and glorify your holy name, O Lord of all, Father and Son and Holy Spirit, forever. Amen. We will be partaking in the Holy Eucharist coming from the middle rather than coming from the side of the church. So I will ask the ushers.
Thank you. Thank you.